Live from Easy K Studios in Eddyville, Kentucky. It's time for the Easy K Show. Tonight, it's Movie News 2, and we talk about those Oscars. What about that Panther? Your hosts, Darth Easy and Rady Cage.
Woohoo!
All right, guys, welcome to another episode of the Easy K Show. I am Darth Easy.
And I'm Rainy Cage.
So this is Movie News 2, so let's get talking about some movie news. First big news story of the month of the episode is Spider-Man Far From Home trailer. What'd you think about that?
I thought it was pretty cool.
Yeah?
I liked it. I'm still interested to see if Mysterio is going to be a good guy for most of this movie, or if he's going to just be a good vibe for the beginning of the movie, because isn't he going to be like the main villain?
Well, he's part of, in the comic books, I believe he's a member of the Sinister Six, and yeah, he's going to be a bad guy.
Because in the trailer, there's a lot of elemental action.
Yeah.
So,
which is supposed to be actually setting up for elementals in later on in the Marvel Universe. That's what they're talking about.
So. And it also looks like Mysterio's fighting one of the elementals, so that's why I'm. But it looks really cool. It's funny. I love that line at the very end where he's like,
"It could be Jake. It could be that Mysterio is an enemy of Spider-Man, but it's that classic phrase: the enemy of my enemy is my friend."
Or it could be all a trick.
It could be all a trick. And then we also get to see Sam Jackson sometime after Infinity War, so it kind of a. This trailer is kind of a big ass spoiler to say, like, everything's fine, nothing to worry about.
But in the trailer, you do, and Happy Hogan says, you're all alone in the trailer, and that's making people think that, oh, maybe Iron Man's dead, maybe Tony Stark's dead in this movie. I saw a lot of chatter about that, reading into that line a little bit more, but I mean, that could be taken out of context, but still. Could be a little bit of a tease that...
Me, personally, I would rather not seen anything from this movie until after April. But I know that's impossible, so...
I love the end scene, though, where he's like, oh, yeah, I like Spider-Man, blah, 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 blah. Then he goes, hey, what's up, dick? Dickhead, or something like that. Yeah, it's really funny.
Yeah. All right, moving on, we have the Ghostbusters 3 teaser for 2020. That's kind of crazy. What do you think about that?
Yeah, you know, it's just the teaser as a whole is just a little CG barn with a Ghostbusters. Yeah. What's that vehicle called in Ghostbusters? We're not the biggest Ghostbuster fans in the world, but
the Ghostbusters car.
Okay, well, the Ghostbusters car.
Maybe like the funeral car.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
And then you just see it. They're like, sweet. I don't know. Did we need another Ghostbusters? People are really high on this franchise.
I need something better. I need a good tonic in my mouth after that horrible Ghostbusters female movie.
Did you hear about Leslie Jones coming
out? She can
go
fuck herself.
And being like, everybody's sexist and racist. And
well, I remember what somebody said. They said, if you don't like Ghostbusters, you're a sexist.
But
it wasn't a good movie. So
I mean, I'll be game for it, I guess. As far as like getting excited, you will not see Ghostbusters on my anticipated list.
No, I agree with you, but it's kind of interesting to talk about. Except that I didn't expect to.
It's pretty crazy. Yeah, it is pretty crazy how quickly they're like. But I mean, this is Sony. They want more franchises. Mm-hmm. They're obviously not going to let Ghostbusters be. So we'll see.
Yeah. Now let's talk about John Wick 3 trailer.
Yes, this looked amazing.
It did look amazing, didn't it?
I mean, it's got me pumped. It made me want to go watch the John Wick movies again, but I'm holding off till we get closer to the release date. But yeah, it looks really cool.
Yeah, it looks fun. I can't wait to watch Keanu Reeves on a horse with two pistols go bam, 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 bam.
It's like Planet of the Apes all over again.
Yeah. John Wick on horses.
Yeah, it looks cool. It's Halle Berry's in this one. There's some new people in here, too.
Yeah, I did also some rehash of old characters with Ian McShane, and it's like taking place like 24 hours after the events of John Wick 2,
which ended pretty crazy.
And basically everyone wants to kill him. The poster is pretty awesome. Everyone's just waving a gun at John Wick, I mean, it's that line for John Wick 2 when he says, "Tell all who come, I'll kill you. I'll kill them all." And it's going to be interesting how this wraps up the trilogy. Even if this even wraps up the trilogy, Keanu Reeves could do this for as long as he wants, and I'll probably keep letting him because these movies make a bunch of money and they're just fun movies, and they're setting up that TV show. So
nothing less, we'll get some really cool action scenes. Yeah, but I have a feeling this is going to be good.
I'm hoping this could be better than the second one because I loved the second one. I didn't like it as much as the first one, but it wasn't far off. So hopefully this third one can be one of the few movies that can be the best of the series.
That's kind of me too. I really like the second one, but I don't think it's as good as the first. Thought it got a little bit ridiculous towards the end, but I'll just go into this one embracing the ridiculousness.
Mm-hmm. All right, now let's get to some Oscar talk.
Okay.
For Best Picture, for was nominated for Best Picture was Black Panther, Black Klansman, Bohemian Rhapsody, The Favorite, The Green Book, Roma, and A Star Is Born, and Vice. So any snubs, any ones you wish that would have got nominated or not?
No, I mean, I don't think there was maybe any snubs in there, none that I can think of off the top of my head. It's cool that Black Panther got nominated.
Yeah, first superhero film. I mean, why is it getting nominated, though? It's because it has a bunch of black people, to be
honest with ourselves. Whoa.
And so I don't think you would have, if you're going to nominate a movie for that, you didn't have to nominate Black Klansman for the exact same reason, because it's going after political issues that are going around today.
Yeah, I would have been more impressed if they had nominated Logan last year. I mean, to me, Logan mm-hmm. is a superior movie and worthy of a Best Picture nomination. But, you know, I'll just go with it and be like, hey, comic book movie got Best Picture nomination. Yeah, that's cool.
Hopefully this isn't let's hope this isn't a race thing, and actually going forward, just because a movie is a comic book film does not mean we can't nominate it.
So who do you think is going to win, and who do you want to win? We kind of do this every year. I think, I have a feeling Roma feels like the kind of the front runner right now.
I won't be surprised if Bohemian Rhapsody wins.
That would be crazy too, because it's kind of got a lot of momentum. I don't know, for me, out of all these movies,
personally, of all the movies, I would like to see Green Book win.
Yeah, me too. I was about to say Star is Born, but I'm with you. I like Green Book better.
Yeah.
But that, for me, I'd be for Green Book
but I
as
think
well.
I won't be surprised if Star is Born wins.
You think they will, or you don't?
I think it will win.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. I think it's not getting a lot of buzz. I don't know. I'd be happy with it, though, if it did.
All right. Let's move on to Best Supporting Actress. Or let's go to director, because I didn't write that down.
Okay. There you go. Spike Lee, Black Klansman, Powell Pawlowski, Cold War, Yorgos Lanthimos, The Favorite, Alfonso Cuarón, I'm butchering these names, I know, Roma, and Adam McKay Vice.
Yeah, there's a lot of interesting people in this. I mean, I don't know who the second guy is, Cold War. Yeah, is that a documentary or something? Or is it like a foreign film?
I have no idea.
I mean, I've heard a lot of talk about it. Yeah. The Favorite, I mean, I thought it was okay directed, but I think the biggest snub to talk about is Bradley Cooper.
Cause yes, I
think
I agree.
He was probably a runaway to win this award, and he didn't even get nominated.
I'm calling Roma's going to win this. Just like I feel like Roma's going to win Best Picture.
I kind of hope Spike Lee wins it, because I thought he directed the hell out of Black Klansman.
I mean, I guess out of these, for me, I'd probably go...
Alfonso Cuarón's already won before Gravity or for... I think he won for Gravity.
I really like The Favorite. It's just the end I didn't like of The Favorite. Mm-hmm. But, you know, as far as direction go, I think I would probably go, for me, Roma. I liked Black Klansman, though. Vice was just meh. So, it is weird that Bradley Cooper did not get nominated for this.
Yeah. All right. Let's talk about Best Supporting Actress.
Okay.
Amy Adams for Vice. Marina de Tavira for Roma. Regina King for If Beale Street Could Talk. Emma Stone for The Favorite. And Erica White's for The Favorite. Who do you think is going to win this?
Who do I think? It's going to be Regina King, because she's running it for everything else. But I didn't see Biff Bill Street Could Talk,
yeah,
so that's like kind of the one I have it out of all these I've seen. So if it was me, I'm going to go Emma Stone, The Favorite.
Yeah, I like to see her win. I also like to see Amy Adams get a fucking Oscar.
That'd be cool.
You've been... Right now, she's Leonardo DiCaprio. She's trying to get that Oscar, and I haven't even seen.
I was saying, she just of all the people in Vice, she's not the one that sticks out to me. I know. Yeah, but
so best support actor, we have Mahershala Ali for Green Book, Adam Driver for Black Klansman, Sam Elliott for Star Is Born, Richard E. Grant for Can You Ever Forgive Me, and Sam Rockwell for Vice. What do you think about these nominations? Cool. Any snubs you can think of? And
I mean, a lot of good nominations. Sam Elliott is a little bit much, considering he's barely in the movie. But
well, I don't know. But he does have a huge role in it, though.
I haven't seen Can You Ever Forgive Me. That was one of the ones I didn't get to watch. Yeah.
I'm glad Adam Driver's getting nominated. I'm glad he's getting some award consideration, because he's probably the best thing to come out of the new Star Wars trilogy. And, I mean, he's done a lot of stuff. I mean, from this, Silence, to that film You Loved Last Year. Adam Driver's he's having a great career so far, and I'm hoping he gets more and more roles like this after he's done with Star Wars.
I'm sitting there trying to think of that film, Logan Lucky.
Yeah, I agree. But I think after this, I think we watch Mahershala Ali walk away with his second Oscar win.
That's what I'm thinking too.
But who knows? They could give it to Sam Elliott or Sam Rockwell again. I don't know. I'm thinking Mahershala Ali though.
Yeah.
All right. So best actor, we have Christian Bale for Vice, Bradley Cooper for Star Is Born, William Dafoe at Eternity's Gate, Rami Malek at Bohemian Rhapsody, Viggo Mortensen for Green Book.
What the heck is that? At Eternity's Gate. This is right off the bat what I was...
That's the story about Vincent Van Gogh, isn't it?
I don't know, but William Dafoe seems to be, like, every year, get a nomination for something.
Did he, though? I don't ever realize
he Yeah, he either. Got one for that hotel movie that I thought was okay, but I didn't understand why he was getting so much love. Anyways, to me, I would go Bradley Cooper. I mean, that's my favorite. But I don't think he'll win it. I think this is Rami Malek's to lose.
Personally, of all these people I've seen, which I've only seen three performances, I think Bradley Cooper's my third favorite performance on here.
Really?
Because I think Rami Malek is incredible as Freddie Mercury. I mean, that's the thing about Bohemian Rhapsody is I think it's an okay movie, but with an incredible performance. But really, I would like to see Viggo Mortensen win. I don't think he win after all those damn comments he made. But I think that damn New York accent, he is so good in that movie. And Bradley Cooper's good in the movie. I mean, he is the thing about the movie that I love the most.
I'm with you. To me, Viggo Mortensen is, if we were just going off performance, he's definitely worthy, but I just think there's no chance.
There's too much politics
involved with this. Yeah, yeah. So I think it's Rami Malek's to lose. But if it was me, I think I'd go Bradley Cooper just because I thought he was really good. But I hear your points. So when Christian Bale does do the whole transformation, kind of like what's his name last year,
Gary Oldman,
yeah, Churchill. And he won last year. But
but it's two different movies.
I know, but it's
people like Winston Churchill. People don't like fucking Dick Cheney.
I tell you, you can barely tell that it's Christian Bale under all that makeup and effects and stuff. But
all right, last thing to talk about, actress. I did not write it down apparently. So you want
to? Oh, okay. Yalitza Aparicio, that's the chick from Roma. Glenn Close, The Wife. Olivia Colman, The Favorite. Lady Gaga, A Star Is Born. Melissa McCarthy, Can You Ever Forgive Me? Apparently, Glenn Close is going to win this. That's what everybody says. And
oh, really?
I've never even seen The Wife, didn't even know what it was, but apparently she's won every actress nomination for every other award, so it's like supposedly a lock. But if it were me, I'd probably go Lady Gaga.
I personally go Olivia Colman.
Olivia Colman was really good.
Because I didn't think Lady Gaga was so incredible in the film. They're just like, oh my god, this is incredible. As a first film, yeah, good job, Lady Gaga. But I thought Olivia Colman was just a lot better in the film.
So. Once again, neither of us saw Can You Ever Forgive Me. Yalitza was pretty good in Roma. I could see her maybe stealing this. Mm-hmm. But I'm with you. Olivia Colman's really good. Lady Gaga, for me, is better, but I think it's going to be Glenn Close. I don't know why. I've never even heard of that movie, but
all right,
as is the Oscars.
That ends our Oscar talk.
Whoa, 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 whoa. You're missing animated features, sir.
I just don't like talking about animated films.
I know, you're an animated film hater.
If films are, if because I hate the category of best animated film, because animated movies are just as good as the best pictures. So you just have this best animated category. It gives them an excuse like, well, we already have the best animated movie. We don't have to nominate it.
I understand, but that's
so that's my heatness of the best animated film.
The way it is, though, and we're not in charge of the Oscars.
I'm just saying, I just don't want to talk about it.
Incredibles 2, Isle of Dogs, Mariah, no one knows what that is, Ralph Breaks the Internet, and Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Now, word on the street is Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse would be the runaway victor here because it's winning all the other animated things on everything.
But Oscars hate superhero films.
Yes,
so.
And it's, you know, Oscars So White was just a year or so ago, so I could see a bunch of...
like 3 years ago, and then ever since then, they've had all these, like, we're sorry, here's Moonlight, here's Black Panther, here's Black Klansman.
You also got to remember, you know, the Oscars like to give Disney stuff for no reason. Remember everybody was up in arms because Brave won Best Animated Picture, and that was the same year I think Wreck-It Ralph or something came out that everybody was like, that should have. And Lego Movie, even though we don't like it, everybody thought Lego Movie should win the Best Animated, and some Disney movie got it. So I'm just saying, there is a chance Incredibles 2 could win it over Spider-Man, and I think that would be a travesty because Spider-Man was clearly the best animated.
I agree with that, but I like Incredibles 2, so there's nothing wrong with that. So,
I think Incredibles 2
or Ralph Breaks the Internet, which I like better than Incredibles 2, more than that. So
I don't know. We'll see.
You done with Oscars?
I guess so.
All right. So moving on, we have James Gunn is to direct Suicide Squad 2. What do you think about this?
That's crazy. And not just is he going to direct it, he apparently is writing the script, and he is like, it's not even going to be like a direct sequel. Like, they're going to pull certain characters from it, but for the most part, it's like a reboot. It's a reboot.
What they're going to do is they're going to pull Deadshot and probably
Margot Robbie,
Harley Quinn's character, and then
everything
else. But that's the thing with Suicide.
Maybe Amanda Waller. Did she survive Suicide Squad? I can't even remember.
Yeah,
she did. Yeah, yeah. So.
But technically, she's the person over there. Yeah. And that's probably a good thing, because Suicide Squad, you can do it with any characters, and, you know, I would kind of like to see Captain Boomerang come back.
Yeah, I like Captain Boomerang.
It's the only performance from that guy I actually like. And the thing about it is, Suicide Squad 2 was basically the first Suicide Squad was trying to be Guardians of the Galaxy, so it could be a good mix with James Gunn.
You think they'll let James Gunn go back to his roots and make this rated R? Because then that would get me even more excited. Because
I hope so.
That would be cool.
I wasn't a big fan of Suicide Squad. Because I want them fighting terrorists. I don't want them fighting a fucking witch that does a Hulu dance the entire film.
Alright. Well, I think it's very interesting. I mean, James Gunn just moving right along. Pretty cool.
But the thing is, I didn't care for Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
I know you didn't.
And, so...
it's too jokey for you. So you don't want Suicide Squad to be like Guardians 2, is what I'm guessing.
Guardians 3, really.
You want it to be not...
I don't want to be as jokey, but that's the thing. We don't know what the fuck is going on with DC right now. One minute we're dark, one minute we're light and comedy, one minute Octopus is playing drugs, another minute...
We never mentioned that, but I don't want you to be obsessing over Octopus is playing drums when you still defend the dude banging the drum in freaking Turn Left the movie.
There's a guitar that shoots flamethrowers. I win. Over. Argument over. All right, and now we pay our homage to Ben Affleck. After months and years of you being Batman, and you say you're done as Batman, you are officially done as Batman. So,
so basically, it was a giant lie, and they were just doing PR for the last 2 years, basically.
Yeah.
He got up on stage at Comic-Con and said, I'll be Batman forever. I'll play an ape for whatever his name is. And it was all a lie, which is kind of
I'm sad
shitty.
About this because I love Ben Affleck's Batman and Batman v Superman. Didn't like him in Justice League just because he was too jokey, because I don't want Batman jokey. And because when we go back to Batman being jokey, we get back to the dark times of Batman with Batman Forever and Batman and Robin.
I can't wait for you to see Aquaman. Because I really feel like the DC universe is going in the happy, jokey area. Yeah. And
I just don't need... if every character can do that, but Batman can't. He just can't.
I mean, Batman's
pretty
serious.
A character whose family gets killed, and he lives in the city where his parents were murdered. I mean, there's nothing joking. You can't just be like, what about their damn parents, man?
I liked Ben Affleck Batman. It's crazy. What was it, 5 or 6 years ago? We were so excited because Ben Affleck was going to direct his own Batman, and
yeah.
Now, I mean, who knows? Let's see who they get. You know what the word is on the street of who it's going to be?
It's going to be Edward or whatever
yep.
his name.
From. Twilight Boy. I can't think of his name now either, but yeah.
I don't know what his name is, but I liked him in Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. All right, let's talk about some of these Super Bowl trailers. There really isn't much. They're not really trailers. They're more teasers, except for the Hobbs and Shaw trailer.
Which I loved.
In-game, basically you're seeing everyone get ready for the big battle, and you see them all walking in a row. You're seeing Nebula and Iron Man fixing up the ship, looks like. And yeah, that's basically all really I remember.
I mean, I really liked it because, once again, we don't really need trailers for Endgame. We're all going to see it. So I like that they're keeping them short, simple, not really giving you any plots. But if you look deep enough in this trailer, there's a few spoilers. I mean, it looks like Tony Stark is back on Earth with the team. So that goes ahead and ruins that last teaser where it looked like he might be dead in space. So, but overall, I think it was cool. It had a good tone. And I'm pumped for Endgame. You know, it was definitely a very serious 30-second spot. No jokes in this one. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I'm pumped.
There wasn't even jokes in the last trailer, though, really. So.
No, the very
Other
end.
But that's Ant-Man.
Yeah.
All right. Toy Story 4.
Oh, this is when he gets strapped to the buzzing. I mean,
I don't know if I'm going to like this, getting stuck in a carnival.
Well, have you read the story? Apparently, is they go looking for Bo Peep. They go on a road trip. But, yeah, I think
that's
it's
the one that Woody was all up with. Yeah.
I think it's going to be significantly, like you say, in a carnival. So, I don't know.
I've been playing Kingdom Hearts all week.
Yeah.
And there's a Toy Story world in it. And it's actually pretty fun and made me really want to go back and watch all the Toy Story films.
Also, maybe you're a little more into Toy Story than the rest of the world, but I'm sure it'll be good. I mean, they have all of them been good so far, so we'll see. But as far as the trailer, it was funny when he gets his foot stuck in what's his name's helmet in Buzz Lightyear's helmet.
Yeah.
But.
Alright, final thing. Oh, no. And then Hobbs and Shaw.
I loved it. The full trailer. I do think it's a little too long, but the little 30 second trailer where they had cut it all down, I like the full, almost 3 minute trailer. I think this movie looks incredible. I was like, holy crap. I was laughing my butt off like the whole time through, and it looks insane like all Fast and Furious has become. But I'm fine with that. I love the scene where he jumps off the building, that whole interaction when he's punching the guy, and then he comes up, smashes the guy in the glass window, and then Jason Statham's sitting there like, haha, you're an idiot. And then he mouths the words, fuck you. And all he's going, oh my God, I lost it. But I think they're going to have great chemistry. I mean, they did in the last Fast and Furious movie. This was really smart for them to do a spin-off of these two characters.
Yeah.
And it just looks like a Bad Boys or a... just a buddy cop movie, but insane.
Yeah.
And the only thing I heard a lot of people complaining, like Christian Hanoff was hardcore about this. He was like, why does Idris Elba need to be a superhero? I'm like, why not?
I agree with that. I do agree with that.
Before long, we're going to be in space with the Fast and Furious movies.
Like,
just let it happen.
Says, like, I'm immune from bullets and everything. Just like, what?
It looks like he's going to get, like, ejections, and he's basically going to be Captain America or something, but...
So, I mean, I've been more interested in Hobbs and Shaw just because I hate it. The Fate of the Furious.
No, you did not. You didn't hate it.
Okay,
went and sat there and saw that at Star Wars Celebration.
We didn't sit at Star Wars Celebration. We saw it after.
Yeah, and you did not hate it.
I just didn't enjoy it because it's just getting more stupid and stupid and stupid. And you're just like, what the fuck's going on? And The Rock punch a fucking nuke.
Yeah, he kicks a torpedo. So.
It's stupid. I just can't.
But you liked Hobbs and Shaw in it, is what you're saying.
Yeah, that was the only thing I liked about that film, was I loved their banter together, and I loved Jason Statham when he was on the airplane with the baby. I thought that was good. Everything else about the movie, eh.
I mean, I remember, we've only watched that once. I bought it, but I haven't rewatched it. I remember not liking what Charlize Theron's character and the whole twist with Vin Diesel, but I still love these movies
because they're just pure entertainment. I also like the trailer had the girl from Fate of the Furious who was in The Crown.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because I like her, and I like seeing her back in the story. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to this.
It's going to be cool summer fun.
Well, it's going to be an October movie. It's November.
No, it's like August.
I'm pretty sure it's like October. So.
Let me look that up while you finish off this story.
I'm pretty much done. So, Disney is going to make R-rated superhero films whenever Fox actually gets involved in the story. So, what do you think about this?
I think that's cool. Really, though, I'm happy because I don't want Deadpool to end, but it's gonna start getting confusing because then okay, so we're gonna have Deadpool. It's clear if it's gonna be rated R, they're not gonna put him in the same universe. He's not gonna be joining the MCU.
The thing is, they can make jokes around it and Deadpool. The whole thing with Time Travel, they're like, oh yeah, now we're part of Marvel. Deadpool will be wearing a
August 2nd for Hobbs and Shaw. By the way,
push up. Yeah. Anyways, I'm looking forward. I don't know. I didn't like Deadpool 2 that much. I know you overhyped it, probably. I didn't think the second one was as funny as the first one. I think the first one's actually a pretty good film. I just thought, but maybe the third one, maybe it'll be a little better. It's going to be.
You said they started writing it already, I think.
It's going to be a while before the next one comes out.
Yeah, I mean, because we're not even finalized on the Disney deal yet. Also, he said, I don't know if you said this, but he said there was. They were thinking about doing other R-rated movies. So that means a movie like Logan could probably still exist. But I just don't know. I mean, we're guessing that X-Men are going to go over to the MCU. But, I mean, I guess they could be like, okay, we're just going to keep X-Men and all our Fox properties separate. And then we can make them R-rated and so put them on Hulu.
They might keep X-Men separate for a little bit. Maybe. But I think they're going to pull. I think they're going to do a Fantastic Four in the next phase of the Marvel films because you can't do the next big bad to do would be Doctor Doom and Galactus and all of them, and those are Fox licensed by Marvel. So those are characters that we need to see. And if we're gonna try to trump Thanos, because the Marvel Cinematic Universe is at such a peak right now. And the only thing to do is you gotta keep going higher and higher, getting more stakes and more characters, and you gotta get better, bigger, better villains.
Or a reset. We don't know how Endgame's gonna go down. I mean,
don't want to see a reset.
We could be nearing reset, and then some of this would make sense, because I agree with people. Integrating the X-Men into the MCU just seems really weird and confusing. So,
they could have been living in hiding and no one really knowing because of other shit going on. So,
I get, or we could just not go,
because there's the thing in the story in the X-Men cartoons where the second X-Men cartoon I watched where no one even knew mutants existed. They lived in hiding, and maybe S.H.I.E.L.D. had information on the X-Men, but they just didn't tell anybody about it. So maybe the X-Men are just trying to live their normal lives. They're recruiting mutants, and then they're just staying in their manor. I think that's the way you could do it.
I mean, you're definitely selling me on it. So
so never mind.
Yeah.
I just don't want to see a reset, because what the fuck was all the 10, 11 years worth? Because yeah. I want to keep seeing the universe going on and going on. I don't want to see, well, we're starting over. Then Marvel's going to be in the same problem DC's in. We're like, well, let's kind of start over. Andrew Cavill, you're out. I think maybe, hey, come back and direct or produce or something. Batman, you're out. We're going to have a whole new Batman. Wonder Woman, we like you. Shazam, we don't know how we feel about you yet. And
don't forget about Aquaman.
And in Suicide Squad, most of you are fired. So, yeah. Yeah. And guys, that ends another episode of the Easy K Show. This was one of our longer movie news episodes, but it had to be with our Oscar talk. So until next week, all too easy.
Peace out.
come.